Good morning. I just figured I'd tell you what I'm doing. Been getting up at, well, it was 3:30, now it's 4:30 in the morning on weekdays. And it's really stupid, but it's like, I look at it as, it's not stupid, it's genius. like I just decided to learn what the stock market's all about, you know? I'm like in this situation where I wanted to grow, I wanted to simplify my life and come out to Hawaii and just be like, I could just farm and live off the land and need nothing, you know? And that, I see my Facebook goals 10 years ago, and that's what I was just like, man, if only I didn't have to play this stupid money game. And just, so I created a situation where I didn't need that. And so it took kind of getting rich, playing the game, and then just getting wiped out. As soon as I was Mr. Money, I was targeted, and I'm just not competitive enough. I'm not aggressive or violent. I'm just not made for that stupid game. I'm not a gangster. Not just some greedy, you know what I mean? I cannot make myself do it. It feels wrong to me. It feels like taking advantage of any situation. I'm not an advantage taker. So, but I mean, I do. I'll take advantage of the situation I'm in if it's, you know, especially if it's conflictual. Flip it upside down, right? How is this weathering gonna help strengthen me, right? So that's where I'm at with it. But yeah, stock market, I looked at it like you know, money comes and goes. Is you just I buy a bunch of pots and soil and grow trees, and Blake steals them, so I can't. I was like, I should have sold them, you know. I should have, like, my land could have been renting and being a manager, but like, look at all the issues I have with people taking advantage of me because of the way I am. It's just, that's not the right position for me. So, I just, you know, like, the money game in itself is just, like, not, my high school counselor was probably, I mean, dude, that's probably a good idea if it's not already happening, to have high school counselors be CIA so they can actually, like, spot the people that are going to be able to be players and whatnot, you know what I mean? So I remember telling my counselor, why do I need money? She's like, well, you have to choose one of these careers on this paper. I'm like, no, I don't. And she looked at me like, you see through this? And I was looking at her like, you actually believe all this crap? And she was like, So, anyway, I was like, I'll be a beach bum. She's like, huh? See how far that'll get you. She's right. I'm sick of that shit. I can't have ideas, and I don't have, like, the capital to make them happen, and that makes me feel slowed down, and I am not okay with that. Like, Hawaii, put me on Hawaii time, and that's part of, you know, you need to let go of that importance, that self-importance, that, that drive, that egotism. You've got to get rid of that shit. I mean, or else you'll just suffer the whole time. So, I figured that out. I'm sure because I figured it out, or mostly I suffer so much still. But in general, I kind of take it all very casually. And compared to everyone else, at least. And that sets people off. The control freaks, the fear mongers, they're just all like, whoa, that guy isn't afraid. He's not conforming. What the hell? We can't have that example around. So, it's a weird thing. Oh, the stock market, dude. I just thought, all right, if I can't make money, you know, like all these other avenues just feel like I either have to take advantage of people or do something illegal or whatever. Crap, dude. It's just like, just feels like you keep blood on your hands no matter what you do, right? I was just like, I'm just going to grow my fruit in Hawaii and be happy and free and alleviate myself of this struggle. And that just brought more struggles. All the social shit. Everyone hates me so much for not being part of the game. They think I'm rich because my attitude shows that I just don't even care. Which must portray, must have like the billionaire attitude, right? So, but I don't care. So it's like, because I don't care about money, because I don't conform, I'm not willing to like pander to people for anything, it comes across as if I am a billionaire. And that might also be why I get taken advantage of so much and people rob me so much and whatever. They're just like, wow, what is a billionaire? But his stuff's just sitting out. Get him! They don't know. They don't know the difference. So I must be emanating that. And I mean, it's true. I have billion-dollar ideas every day, and I just don't jump on them because it would make me that guy. And I'm not that guy. So anyway, stock market. I went back in to learn. I threw $1,000 on the market, whittled it down to like three. I was like, man, I'm really bad at this, you know, buying into blockchain and stuff. It was just like 400 into 100, like all this crap. Now it's like $10. Now it's time to grab it. So I'm learning. That's the point. I spent $1,000 on stock market school. And I watched it and I played with it and it, like it was a video game, and I was like, okay, so this dollar, every time I'm buying a dollar of a stock, I can pretend it's a million. You know? And if that's the case, then my first year in the stock market I lost like $10 million, and then $100 million, $700 million. There we go. yeah, fail. And then my buddy, oh shit, am I admitting to insider trading? No, I don't know anything about the stock market. So I was sitting in a hot tub and my friend dares me to fucking buy $1,000 worth of AMC. I'm like, okay, I already said I wasn't going to spend more than this $1,000, and I whittled it down to $300, but I'm balling in. I'm in a hot tub with a bunch of cute girls. I'll do it. Bing. And he's like, you're going to regret that you didn't put $2 on it. I'm like, should I? Almost did. The next day, well, no, the next day it was down like 970 or something. I was like, great. And then the next day, $4,600. I was like, whoa, I'm pulling out my 36 profit and leaving the 1,000, let it ride. And then, of course, the 1,000 went down almost to nothing, right? But $3,600 profit right off the bat, baby. That was fun. And if that was millions, then I just made my $1 billion, or $3 billion off of, wait, I just made a third of a billion. Anyway, there's numbers. And I could have made more numbers. And, right? Because I was learning and just pretending that my zeros were... Anywho, I've been playing it now for 2 years, 2.5. And that, I still did a lot of learning curve losses. I thought I was smarter, Watching every day what I could have done to maximize my gains. I'm like, man, how could I have known that that company was going to do that today? How could I have known that that shit, you know what I mean? So, I did research. I was like, wow, you can set your phone to tell you when the market report or when their earnings reports are coming out. And then these companies, you can look into them and see what their projections are. And, you know, I am barely touching the surface. I haven't even started short selling. Well, there was that little experience while Blake was here. And, right, he got me in XRP and that trading thing. And I put in $200 and turned it into $1,800 the next day. And I was like, what do I do, Blake? Do I hold it? Do I sell? He's like, hold it. I'm like, no, I should sell, right? And then it was gone entirely the next morning because we went to sleep. So it's like I learned right then. Listen to yourself, not Blake. And then... Dude. Anyway. Investments, dude. Every time I eat a fruit, that seed, I'm looking at it like a future tree that could produce everything we need. So, it's not that hard for me to see stocks when they're... You know, I'm like, is this thing going away? No, it's staying around. Is it going any lower? No. Well, guess what, dude? That's like JC's grandma when Chevron was 90 cents, dude. Anyway. I'm going to start a playlist on my YouTube called Stock Market Psychology or something. And then... I guess it's going to be part of the learning channel.